evening, everyone. Good evening to all the cabin crew members here. So I'm Amisha Saxena. I am from Aircruise Aviation Private Limited, and I'm going to tell you about the cabin crew requirements, question answers, and the benefits of the cabin crew of the Emirates Group. Okay. So Emirates is world's largest airlines, and it has its hub in Dubai. It has served to the six continents every day. It is one of the largest airlines in India, and it has more than 3,600 flights per way. And we just travel to more than 161 cities across the six continents. Okay, so now I will tell you about quick overview of the Emirates Airlines. So it was founded in 25th March 1985, and it has its hub in Dubai International Airport. And its key peoples are the Ahmed bin Zayed Ali Mokhtoum. He's the chairman and the CEO. And you can check our website at www.emirates.com. Okay, so here I present you all must know about the cabin crew. Who are they? They work for the safety and for providing comfortable services to the passengers. So that's the main requirement. Like, we want the best crew members on our board. So the requirements for the Emirates cabin crew members are that they should have an arm reach of 212 while standing on their tiptoes. They should have a minimum age of 21 years, and their height should be of 160 centimeter. They should be a graduate from, they should be a high school graduate. That is, the minimum qualification is grade 12, but they should be fluent with their English, that is in professional or in written spoken. You don't have to have visible tattoos on your body while you are wearing the Emirates uniform, and you should have a fit body mass index, and you should be very adaptable to the different people, different places, and different situation, because cabin crew members deals daily with the different peoples, and they have to live and deal with every situation. Okay, so for applying for this, you can apply via the Emirates Group Carriers website or by the open day call. So first I would like to tell you about the photos and the documents which are needed. So first one is an updated resume. You should have one updated resume, one full length photograph, one passport size photograph, one full length casual photograph, and one half length casual photograph. The full length photograph in business attire should be very professional, and it should be in white background. And you should be straight facing towards the camera, and it should be taken with a white background, right? And for the casual photos, in that also you have to wear normal clothes, but it should be plain, and it should also be well fitted to you. Okay, so you can apply via open days. In open days, you visit to the Emirates interview place, and there the recruiters will introduce you with the company, and we will let you know about all the benefits of being an Emirates cabin crew member. And when lucky members of you will be shortlisted, then we will inform you. Okay. So these are the short questions which can be asked, like, what do you want? Why do you want to be a cabin crew member? What do you know about Emirates? What do you think the role of cabin crew is? And tell me about yourself. Okay. So the next round is assessment day. Here you are checked on the basis of your personality, and the behavioral questions are being asked. And if the person selects this, then they go for the final interview, and then they will have a personality test again, where they will be asked behavioral questions, and then the golden call is given to the selected candidates. Then their medical testing happens for checking their BMI index, and then they are given the joining letter. And at last, the selected members, they are called for the Emirates Aviation College crew training. Okay. So now I would like to tell you about some benefits which our Emirates provides to the cabin crew member. They got a basic monthly salary of 400 to 600 AED, which is an Dubai Arab currency. Okay. So, and for flying pay, you also get a flying pay, which is 57 AED if you deliver more than 82 or less than 110 flying hours per month. Okay. And there is also overnight allowance, which is also provided. Like if you stay over after a flight, you stay over something, then you don't have to bill for the hotel bills, right? We will be paying your hotel bills. We will be paying your food and drinking bills. And we also provide accommodation and transport benefits. Shared accommodation is provided to newly recruited crew members, and there you will be sharing it with someone else. And we will be paying your electricity, your water bills, but you have to pay your other expenses on your own. Okay. And choice of accommodation is also given to all those people who have done 6 months of their professional, who have completed their 6 months of probationary period, and then you can choose if you wish to choose to go to a different department, right? And married persons accommodation allowance is also provided. If you are married and you don't want to live with someone else, then you can tell about that. We can tell about that to us, and then we will provide you monthly accommodation allowance. And transport allowance is also provided, as you have to visit from your accommodation to the airport, then we will be paying the fees for that. And our company don't provide you pension like other governments or sectors, but we will provide you end of service benefit, where you will be paid 21 days final basic salary of five years on a complete lump sum basis, right? And we also provide some extra benefit, that is uniform. Your uniform will be fully paid by us. You don't have to pay for anything like that. And we will also give you an annual leave ticket, where you will be getting one free return ticket to your home country, but it's only for your home country and not to any other country, right? We will also give you special tickets, where you can nominate your 20 friends or your family, and they will get a discount over that. And we also provide CAT 80, 90 flights, where you can buy unlimited tickets with 90% of discount. But this discount is also limited to your family, close family, immediate family, that is. Some more benefits are like face card, flight attendants, club of Emirates, where you will get special discount whenever you go in Dubai and Gulf regions, beach, clubs, restaurants, gyms, and retail shops. You will get good discount over that. And a platinum card is also provided. If you just want to get more discount on those things, then you can just pay a normal small monthly fee. Then you will get that huge discounts. Okay. And the last one is luxury layover hotels. As I told you, like, you will be provided hotels if you overstay somewhere, then that hotels will be 4 to 5 star hotels, and they will be situated in the center of the city center or in near the airport. Okay, so now I will tell you about some question answers which can be asked for your interview with our company. So first question will be, tell us something about yourself. This is the main question which can be asked by every candidate. So prepare well and be professional by the way of describing yourself. You have to tell about your work experience. You can tell about your interest. You can tell about how your personality is. And these small questions reflect you in a better way. Okay. So second one is, what do you want to know about our airline? So if you are coming and applying to our airlines, then you should know about our company first. It's the most important thing. You should know when Emirates was founded, how big are us, and how many aircrafts we have, and if we have any mergers, like, you should know about that. You should know about the CEO of the firm, right? the third question is, what made you want to apply to become a flight attendant? It is one of the most important question. Like, it tells us like why you are interested in doing this job. Like, you are not doing this by the force of someone, right? You should be doing it with your own interest. We should get to know like you are the best and the right person for ourselves. Okay, so next one, what do you think are your best qualities? You should mention your best qualities and not those qualities which are like normal further, which don't make you exceptional from others. Okay, so we should know like what are the good qualities you have for being a good flight attendant. Like, you should have good professional skills, you should know how to talk, you should know how to talk, handle different situation, should know how to handle pressure. Okay, so the next question is, what skills should a member of an airline cabin crew be expected to have? So definitely this is the general question, right? You should have a good communication skills, and you should followed by the, you know, listening and understanding skills. You should understand the feelings of the every passengers there. You should be able to deliver them your best services, right? So as the main job of the cabin crew is to serve the passengers in a very good and polite way. Okay, so next question is, how would you handle a pressure who is being rude to you or another flight attendants? This is a behavioral question which can be asked to you. So you should handle pressure rightly, and you should not be rude to someone even though they are rude, right? We are working for them, so we should be polite for them, right? So you should tell about your good qualities in this. Okay, so last one is, do you work better as a part of a team or on your own? As a member of cabin crew, you need to work as a part of team, right? But you also work as an individual. So, sometimes there might be situation where you have to handle everything on your own due to any issues that can happen during airline or... So you need to be good with your teamwork skills, and you have to be comfortable by working on your own. In case you are not comfortable enjoying working with a team, you can definitely say you are good in working on your own. So that's all about me. So thank you.